Illinois is moving up when it comes to producing greener energy. The state now ranks 17th in solar production, up from 33rd 3 years ago.
It comes as the U.S. tries to convince other big countries to curb greenhouse emissions. WGN's Sean Lewis reports.
In South Korea this weekend, U.S. climate envoy John Kerry meeting with world leaders as the U.S. prepares to host a virtual climate summit beginning on Earth Day, April 22nd.
And we hope to raise ambition among all nations over the course of these next months.
The Biden administration reversing course on U.S. policy over the last 4 years on climate and pushing now toward green energy production and jobs on an accelerated timeline.
This is not based on politics. This is not about ideology. This is not great power competition. This is about science and what the science is telling us we are doing to our planet.
In Illinois,
the trend is going toward renewable energy, and that's really the only way to save the planet.
Companies like Headline Solar and Suburban Schaumburg are seeing a rapid increase in customers installing solar panels. While critics say it does little to reduce pollution in the end, advocates say it's better over the long term for the environment and the budget, as government rebates help offset costs.
By and large, the motivation is savings, money, you know, financial savings. In the summertime, you're going to overproduce. And then in our winter, you know, just this past winter, we had 2 feet of snow dumped on us overnight. You may not be producing as much right then, but it's going to offset in the summertime when, you know, when the weather's booming and it's beautiful outside.
He says solar and wind farms, some of which are in Illinois, are increasing in size and production of energy as fossil fuel plants are taken offline. Some liken the change to the early 20th century as the rise of the Model T meant an end to blacksmithing. The White House virtual summit, which will be streamed online, will call on major countries to curb greenhouse emissions.
A lot of industrialized countries that are contributing to this challenge. 20 nations, all of whom are invited to President Biden's summit, are responsible for about 81% of all the emissions. So to solve this problem, those 20 countries have to lead the way.
Sean Lewis, WGN News.